My name is Andrew Neethling, 27 years old. I'm from Somerset West, South Africa. Pietermaritzburg is definitely a pretty different venue for us. You know, we're used to being in high up in the mountains using ski lifts. So for me, I'm used to it. You know, I've raced there over the years, doing nationals and stuff, and I know the town well, but I'm sure for the foreigners coming in, they're like, whoa, you know, where are we going? It's nothing new to me, but it shows the diversity of South Africa, the different ethnic races and stuff like that. But for me, I mean, it's pretty normal, you know, it's the country I grew up in. The first World Cup's always really different, I guess, to the others, you know. Especially this one came around really quickly. First race, it's pretty cool to have it in South Africa. I just had a little internal flight up here, and fuck, I can't believe the season's here already. It's like summer break and we're back at school, you know. Just want to have a lot of fun, and the course, a few changes we're going to go see now on course walk, so it should be good. Normally try walk with the team, so we all have a good idea of what maybe I'm talking about when I come down. And
even if you go lower here, like if you take the inside next to the stump, and yeah, if you go low here, then you still have time to come over this side.
You're just trying to get everything ready for a race run. It's actually almost better to jump like a little bit further. Whatever you can learn when you're walking the track, you know, you're going a lot slower, so you can see a lot more.
Judging by some of the turns up there, we need to like increase the compression, but then take off some of that bottom out.
The mystery of the first World Cup is just that. It's a total mystery because you don't know what everybody else has been doing in the off season. You only know what you've been doing in the off season. The first race kind of sets the playing field for at least a few races. We have Danny coming off World Champs win. It's a double-edged sword. It's got its benefit of lots more product, lots more intention of results and things on that side, but it's also more pressure, so.
Here's what it is, addition to the bike race. But now, I guess once I get up there and the time when you can hear them beeps, it'll be a bit pre-race nerves.
Andrew Neethling, you know, South African guy at a home World Cup is amazing. There's a lot of pressure there too, but also a ton of excitement to do well. It's a unique opportunity to race in your home country for a World Cup, and it being the first World Cup is kind of an extra pressure, but also gives you the opportunity to really shine.
Practice at a World Cup, I mean, like we say when we walk the course, you know, you've got to get to know the course first. If it's a new track, you've got to do a few runs just to sort of memorize that course. But at the end of the day, we're trying to just learn as much as we can so that in our race, you know, we can put down our best race run. And that's, you know, from where to brake, where to push it, where to be cautious, where to pedal, what gears to use. You know, so in practice, you've got to learn where you can do all these things. So in a day, it's vital for us to sort of make practice count. Pietermaritzburg in the past, I mean, all signs have showed that I would do well or knock on the podium door, but last year was a nightmare. Qualified solid and ended up crashing in the second turn and crashing again. 09 was okay, I got good points, but I didn't reach a goal of getting on the podium, so I think I've put a lot of pressure on myself to do well. So Maritzburg is a pretty fun section. You know, they call it the gully, and it's so high speed. Two big tabletops, which are pretty rad, but you kind of know in the air of the second one, you've got to get your stuff in a pile because there's this absolutely hateful slog of a pedal coming up for as far as the eye can see. You've got to be able to go fast and be comfortable at speed, and then you know, have a decent bit of fitness to get you to the bottom. It's 4 odd minutes. Danny Hart, my teammate, he's achieved quite a lot for a little youngster. I think a lot of people are looking at him with that jersey, but I think he's young and he's shown his speed, so he's a pretty exciting rider to watch. You know, it's good to ride with him. It keeps me sort of pushing forward and trying to get better, so that's cool. One of my last runs of the day, I just somehow came out of the tree section at the bottom, and I got my head and shoulder around the tree, but my bar with my hand on it just absolutely smashed the tree. So I knew I'd done something wrong because it was swelling up and it was pretty sore. I kind of didn't want to sort of admit to myself that I'd have, you know, any disadvantage going into the race. So.
From midway down this course, it's one of the better courses to hurt your hand, so it's not too bad. Hopefully I can hold on, you know, like as good as I want to ride, you know.
Qualifying's cool because you know, that's where you see who's going fast on the track in general. But to see it at the first World Cup is even that, it's that first glimpse that you get of who's gonna sort in where. I'm excited, you know, I get goosebumps like kind of periodically all day long. So it's where the action really begins is today.
Lost a few spaces to the big lads and I was dead at the bottom, so you know, it's a good sign, and we'll work tomorrow and we'll find a few more seconds.
Just got back from dinner. Gonna go get some ice. Dump my hand in the ice bucket there a couple times before I go to bed. Who knows, there could be something wrong, maybe it's minor, but for sure it's pretty swollen. Does it look massive?
Yeah.
See, I'm trying to ignore it, but everyone's like, whoa, man, that's pretty swollen. The night before the race kind of sucks. Trying to not think about it. I'm going to honestly try watch golf and just think about something else, but for sure there's nerves. Just before the race, I don't know, I think my team's learned that I probably do better when I'm having a good time or just relax, so.
Ready to do this dance?
Yeah.
Ready for shreddy?
I don't really remember too much, but I'm pretty sure we just joke around and.
See those things on your handlebars? Don't use those. Only when you have to.
You know, tease each other, just keep it lighthearted. The serious stuff comes at the top of the hill when you're warming up, training, and you're focusing.
Hey, good luck, dude. Kill it.
Just on the hand, he's got a little bit of pain, so he's taken something for it. He's not quite sure what to expect. I know he's going to give it 120% out there. The home crowd is actually going to lift his game.
Man, the crowd was awesome. I think they were cool for everyone, but obviously they have a little bit biased towards the South Africans, so it was pretty rad. I did not imagine for 1 second how loud the roar would be and how supportive everyone was.
It wasn't really like that I'd done that well, it's just that I had a clean, solid run. It's been 3 attempts now, like since early 09, that I've just wanted to do well at home. So happy, but like you're never really satisfied. I didn't really care. That was my little win, is to get down safe and start the season well and overcome adversity, you know?
He needs to take care of his hands. We have still a month and something to the next World Cup, but should take care of that.
Dude, I'm so fucking emotional when I crossed the line, because it was clean. Dude. I think I celebrated like I won the World Champs. Going home. It's not often after World Cup I go home, is it? It's normally just the end of the season.
Where are we needed?
Cape Town.
Cape Town.
You should just ask.
Who's this guy?
Oh, some
Brendo.
It's that mouthpiece that we found on the plane. So after the race had fellow racer, good friend Brendan Faircloth, decided to come hang out. We've been good friends over the years. Close second is fierce competitors, which I'm sure you'll see rubs off in every minute of the day.
I'm dropping dog at the airport, I don't want him around anymore. Going to the doctor.
First priority was to get this hand checked out, so I was lucky to know of a hand specialist and hand clinic in Cape Town, so I called him up and booked like a rushed appointment when I was in Maritzburg, and he saw me on Tuesday morning.
This is the uric broken. Exactly as we describe the neck of the metacarpal. It's a classic boxer fracture. So this is going to heal fantastically. It's got a beautiful blood supply. So within 3 weeks, it's almost completely healed.
So what do you say?
He said Greg did pretty well on the weekend.
I see Mano did well, eh?
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, I did. It wasn't too bad, eh?
That was pretty awesome.
Did I just smoke you at the first round with a dicky hand?
I got a broken foot.
No, you don't. No, you don't. Yeah, I mean, with an injury like this, you know, it's quite, you do so much with your hands, especially in our sport. So even training, like, it's just going to force me not to ride downhill, which it's not the best thing, but then again, I can have a good break and be hungry for it when I get back. I think when you're training, you just got to find things to motivate you. And I think my goals moving forward are to be consistent. I want to be consistent and fight every weekend and, you know, be right there or thereabouts. And, you know, that's fighting for podiums and a win. You know, I haven't done it yet, but that doesn't mean that's not one of my goals and what drives me. Seventh is great to start the year off, and maybe everyone's pumped because it was on a small injury, but end of the day, I'm aiming way higher. I want to do better each race. Might be happy, but I'm never satisfied, so I don't know. I'm jealous of the guys that win. I want to do that.